For the auto industry, the most competitive race is no longer on the track, but rather in the design studios and development labs, on test benches, and in functional prototypes. It's a race to market on a course inspired by consumer demand for enhanced designs, perfected technologies, and an all-encompassing commitment to absolute quality.
Der Markt hat sich natürlich in der Vergangenheit und gerade in den letzten 5 Jahren.
Yes, the marketplace has changed drastically, especially in the last 5 years. We have to react much faster to the marketplace. Today, there are numerous competitors who attempt to compete in our market segment. I believe, however, that we have succeeded in maintaining our leading position. But it is obvious that competition forces us to be very active with regard to cost, quality, and technology. Therefore, we have to try to be in the forefront with the technologies we utilize in development.
To meet these changing market conditions, auto manufacturers from around the world are turning to advanced rapid prototyping technologies. We've asked a number of distinguished automakers and first-tier suppliers to discuss their experience with these technologies, in particular, stereolithography, and its effect on time, cost, and quality.
Le produit que l'on lance, quel qu'il soit, doit être bon au lancement.
The product being launched, whatever it is, must be perfect when it is introduced. To have good quality product at the onset, it is essential to be able to test it early in the process. To be able to test it, real parts are needed to evaluate all operating or manufacturing conditions. Rapid prototyping is the only method available today to validate all these stages.
Motorsport is a product development.
Yes, racing is product development under tougher conditions. We are forced to test our parts, our components, in a way that is considerably tougher, harder, and faster. I think, first of all, this new technology enables us to arrive at a meaningful prototype in a considerably shorter period of time, and I believe we are able to create more prototype iterations without straining our expenditures and time frames. I believe we can thereby offer our customers a more mature product in a shorter period of time.
One of the greatest things about being able to generate a three-dimensional physical property up front is the fact it can be used as a communication tool with outside suppliers. You can give it to a die maker, or you can give it to a tool maker, and they will understand exactly what the requirements are. We can use it also to get a better leveling of our costs when we do estimates with the vendors on the outside, because people are less inclined to pad an estimate if they know exactly what's required, so we start getting a lot more competitive costing.
We have been able to bring our products to market in a quicker time frame through the use of rapid prototyping tooling, being able to show our customers a concept at a much earlier stage in their program, and being able to validate that concept at a much earlier stage, which is very important to the final reduction of time for that program.
For the appropriate parts, we can generate more design iterations in less time and less money, and that means we can really optimize our design and our product, and that's very important to General Motors in terms of focusing and maintaining our focus on producing quality parts.
This is an older product that I can show you that we did that for our truck customer. This is a door bezel. It may look fairly simple to the eye, but actually there's quite a bit of engineering involved in making all these parts fit together so that they look good, feel good, and function properly. We went through 5 iterations with our product engineer in order to develop what the customer really wanted. In fact, we were able to actually bypass building any prototype tools by using stereolithography to go through the entire prototype process, and it saved us about 16 weeks and over $500,000 just on this product.
Stereolithography is a process that translates CAD designs into solid objects through a combination of laser, photochemistry, and software technologies. With 3D system stereolithography apparatus, or SLA, CAD data of the product design is first sliced into very thin cross-sections. An ultraviolet laser beam is then focused onto the surface of a vat of liquid photopolymer. The laser traces the cross-section of the part, turning a thin layer of the liquid plastic to solid. The cross-section is lowered and recoated with liquid photopolymer, and the laser traces the next slice on top of the previous one. The process continues, layer by layer, until the part is complete. Unattended, the SLA works around the clock. Without tooling, machining, or cutting, a three-dimensional part is built in a matter of hours. As automotive technology becomes more complex, product development specialists are finding increasing benefits from stereolithography.
There are parts, of course, which we previously could not produce. These are parts for airflow tests, for instance, which have to contain appropriate hollow spaces. In addition, we never had representations of certain ribs, but had virtually limited ourselves to focusing only on creating the outer contours. With this new technology, we are also able to test the physical properties of the wall so that we can recognize early on whether we can include the components as designed in the tool production.
Due to the transparent quality of epoxy resins, we can conduct meaningful tests early on. We pump water into this component, then we add defined air bubbles to this cooling water. These air bubbles are a measure for us of turbulent and laminar flow characteristics. They enable us to quickly recognize critical areas, for example, uncooled areas, and to modify them if needed.
I think rapid prototyping is especially important in the air conditioning business that we're in because of the fact that you have the ability to manufacture very complex parts with very specific detail.
The other part I have over here is certainly one which I find very exciting indeed. It illustrates so many of the things that you can do with SLA which are almost impossible with any other technique. This one is a fairly ordinary component in some respects, and it's just a fuse box for a vehicle, but the internal complexity of this part is tremendous. The fine detail is all there, and that then allowed us to use the molding process to make this part a number of times.
Here we can see a geometric piece which has to be optimized. We have cut out this critical area, redesigned it in our CAD system, produced it using rapid prototyping, and reinserted it here. That means we can build variants in a very short period of time at a very attractive cost without having to redo the component's entire geometry.
One dramatic success story that I can share with you was called the Maestro Project. The system incorporated a number of units, such as an advanced audio unit, climate control unit, hands-free cellular phone, and a number of other functions. Each one of the buttons, and there were more than 108 of them, would have had to have an individual master generated by hand and a physical tool created, and we eliminated all of those steps. We were able to make the parts completely in stereolithography, eliminating the traditional tool-making process, and actually put stereolithography parts in for form, fit, and function, and have an operating unit. We were able to produce the entire physical entity in a four-month time frame, and more than meet their timing and cost expectations. I doubt that we would have been able to use conventional technology to meet that timeline.
When stereolithography was first introduced, prototype parts were used primarily for concept modeling, design verification, and form, fit, and function testing. But as the process has matured, the applications have expanded dramatically.
The most interesting component was, without question, the crankcase. We had asked ourselves, how can we economically create functional test components? We realized that by utilizing the quick cast technique, we could quickly create parts for small lot sizes with near die-cast quality, say 10 to 50 parts, and thus achieve a time reduction of 40 to 50%.
Stereolithography has had a major impact on the lead times and on the way we actually produce prototype parts. It's gone on from just producing prototypes to the production of prototype tooling and ultimately production tooling. It's had an incredible impact.
We start using this technology really the moment that our designs are finished. After the design is really foolproof and this is what the customer really wants, then we will proceed sometimes to use those stereolithography models as patterns for other tooling technologies such as silicon rubber molding, epoxy molds, or spray metal tools, where we can create additional copies if required.
By utilizing rapid prototyping, and especially stereolithography, we build parts that are very similar to the ones in serial production in a very short period of time. QuickCast, derived from this process, enables us, for instance, to build engines which already contain die-cast-like parts. That is, in my opinion, tremendous progress, because in the past, you first had to use sand mold casting.
There's an awful lot of applications that where you can use it. One of the prime factors at the moment, I think, is the niche market car. The ability to produce quick, cheap, quality tooling, to be able to live up to these niche markets, and the ability to change very, very quickly to another model is tremendous.
In response to a highly competitive market, automakers and suppliers are forging stronger, more interactive partnerships.
Nos relations avec nos principaux clients sont des relations de confiance.
Our relationships with our principal clients are based on trust, and to a greater and greater degree, they are asking us to enter into partnerships with them. And they are asking us to help them reduce the time period of their design process. We are required to intervene much earlier, from the time of the original idea, and to intervene very early in order to be able to provide product and prototypes very early in our clients' design process.
It's very important for first-tier suppliers to have a very close relationship with the automotive industry. And they are really, the automotive industry depends upon us to supply technology, to supply more of the engineering that years ago they used to do themselves. In order for us to do that, we have to make sure that we have the ability to have the engineering expertise, the prototyping skills that allow us to bring our products and our designs and our concepts to market in a quicker time frame.
Ja, der größte Vorteil, den wir haben, dass wir sehr schnell.
Well, the biggest edge we have is that we're able to present the customer very early in the bidding phase with a part which corresponds to the one under development. That means if we submit a bid today, we are frequently able to show the customer a part that has not yet been developed. And that is, of course, a very important criterion for being awarded the contract.
Mais personne aujourd'hui ne peut prendre une décision.
Nobody can make a decision which involves the implementation of huge sums of money, several billion francs or dollars, the implementation of significant teams, several hundred people. Nobody wants to make an important decision without seeing and holding a real part. We are able to supply our clients with real parts, with unbeatable deadlines, and with quality which cannot be found elsewhere.
Many modifications, many iterations are triggered by a discussion around a completed stereolithography component, because in view of all kinds of possible graphical representations of modern three-dimensional chain models, it is imperative today that when confronted with complex components that the designer and the tester be able to hold the components in their hands.
Ja, bei uns ist die Stereografie seit 1990 im Einsatz.
Well, we have been using stereolithography since 1990. Our decision was, simply, five-axis milling machines or stereolithography, due to the fact that we were receiving orders from our customers who were going 3D, and we just couldn't compete anymore with our conventional machines.
Stereolithography and rapid prototyping is pretty much a standard part of our business operation. We build 2,000 models a year, just internally, and that's growing all the time, and plus we're learning new and greater applications for this technology as well, as it goes beyond just building parts.
Well, the time to market of vehicles is coming down all the time, and every car manufacturer is using the best technologies they can, and it's then a function of how well you can use those technologies to best effect.
Time to market. Cost reduction, innovative designs, and a never-ending quest for quality. These are the new criteria for automotive performance, and this is the course on which all suppliers must compete.
There is no choice. We have to use the rapid prototyping systems to their maximum advantage to remain competitive.